to Portland Wrestling Uncut. Making their way to the ringside area, the Blanchard Brothers, Mr. Ooh La La, and Mike Santiago. Mike, what are you doing with the tag team champions, the Blanchards?
You know, Joe V, I've been getting doubted here, and it's apparent that Mike Santiago is not a tag team wrestler. I lost to Colt Toombs and Pat Large. So, to be considered the best, what do? You just align yourself with, well, the best. They got the gold. You know what? Why don't you tell them?
Jeremy.
Mike Santiago came out here, and he aligned himself with the best tag team in the Pacific Northwest. Smartest move he's made so far. You see, he's not a tag team wrestler, but this guy's a buzzsaw, let me tell you something. But real quick, the only problem I have is you know what? Last week you came out here, we had to have a match because of you. But that has a little trickle-down effect.
What's that, Teddy?
Because of what you did, you got Matt Bourne involved with those two? Do you know who Matt, you know what? What?
Bubba? Ooh La La, the world's greatest life coach? Yeah, they got Matt Bourne involved, but what did Mr. Ooh La La do? He got Mike Santiago, the heat-seeking Puerto Rican involved. That's what he did. That's what he did. Mr. Ooh La La did that. The life coach did that.
No offense, but you're not Matt Bourne. I mean, Matt Bourne's
right. He's not in his 50s, all broken down from hard living. He just happens to be a young lion.
He's not clowning around, all right?
Hey, I'm not taking anything away from him.
Now, guys, I happen to know that Colt, Patrick, and Matt are waiting backstage. Any words for him?
Any words for him? Boys, get ready, because you're in big trouble.
All right, the Blanchard Brothers and Mike Santiago, you know what? It's time for a six-man match, guys. Get in the ring. We're going to bring out Colt Toombs, Patrick Large, and the maniac, Matt Bourne.
Well, Colt Toombs, Pat Large, and Matt Bourne. That's my son there. Joe, you're back with us.
All right.
Thank
you. Yeah, hi, everybody.
No, I was just, hi, how you doing? I was just mentioning that... my son seems to be getting a little bit of trouble lately.
He has.
He gets it from his mother.
I'm sure he does.
I'm glad to be back with you, Joe V.
Yes,
but Mike Santiago, the Puerto Rican, is that what he called
him? The heat-seeking
Puerto Rican. The heat-seeking Puerto Rican.
That's
pardon
his nickname.
My apologies.
There you go.
And I guess they got something to prove here.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, in the booth, of course, with the Hall of Famer, Rowdy Roddy Piper, Portland Wrestling Uncut. Kicking off with a six-man tag, Jovi in the booth once again. Hey, I wanted to let you folks know our friend Don Cost will be back next week. I've been filling in for
yes.
Don. Uncle Don will be back for those of you wondering about that. And we are kicking off in a big way with a six-man match. Rod, as you know, a couple weeks ago, Colt and Patrick beat the Blanchard Brothers, the tag team champions, got the pinfall in what they thought was a title match. It turned out, though, that they were outsmarted by Mr. Ooh La La.
See that? That in itself makes me worry about my son, that he was outsmarted by Mr. Ooh La La, but I'm expecting him to be, you know, and let's make up for it, Colt. Come on, Team Toombs here.
Yeah.
And you got Patrick Large there, you got Matt Bourne. And
you ready for this?
And Bubba Blanchard, who likes to talk as much as he likes to wrestle, maybe even more so. The guy is cut. You can always hear what's on his mind when he's in the ring there, Ron.
Yeah, you can. And the dandy shorts he's been wearing lately.
He's a sharp dresser. Well, he's getting fashion advice from Mr. La La. They're color coordinated. I don't know if you can tell.
Yes, and now Colt doing a good job on the wrist. Oh, reversed. Bubba knowing what he's doing. Colt Toombs had a good job there. Going against the small bones. When you get a big man like that, the wrist work. Nice. Nice reversal, Mike Colt.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we have some big matches tonight. In our main event, it's going to be Thunder against the Tokyo Monster Cahagas. At stake, Wade Hess's contract with the Grappler. Thunder has to pin the Tokyo Monster tonight, Rod, to free his friend.
You know, Thunder, nice suplex by Colt. Thunder, and again, Colt trying to go for it. Bubba, the old pro, right away goes to the home with the headlock. Hanging
look at
on
this.
To Colt. Nice suplex again.
Where did he get that strength from, Rod?
His mother.
There you go.
Colt firing on him. Let me see where he's got going. Nice.
All right, Colt Toombs, he's got a front face lock, it looks like, and he pulled down Bubba. kind of a busted move, but he made something out of it there.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, Colt, you know, still trying to get experience. My goodness, the look on Colt's face sometimes. There goes the big grape. Got Matt Bourne in his corner. You know, Patrick Large and Colt Toombs, they've been having troubles. It's not so easy.
Matt said, hey, I can be your mentor. I've been there. I've been the young up-and-comer, second-generation wrestler just like Colt. Now, wait, what is this?
They're going for a test of strength.
Test of strength. Now,
give your partner with the help.
Colt's a strong guy, but Bubba, that's a big piece of meat there to have a test of strength.
That's a big piece. Colt's pretty strong in that department.
No, wait, he's saying he'll have a test of strength with both of them?
Okay.
Okay. Now, this I've not seen.
No, I've not seen this. We're missing two hands. Okay.
A handicap test of strength. And they're kicking it
right into the hollow. The hills are alive with the sound of music.
I didn't know that big man had so much stretch to him. Look at that, Bubba! Double drop kick
into
Bubba.
The splits.
My goodness.
Bubba's not made to bend that way. Here, Patrick's grabbing Bubba, getting him back in the ring. And, Bubba catches him with a hard uppercut.
All right, Bubba quits hitting those high notes to get back to business there on Patrick Large. Throws him down to the ground, and looks like he's tagging in his brother, Jeremy Blanchard. Here he goes.
Yeah, Bubba's a little stretched out there, I'd say. Nice arm drag by Patrick.
All right, Rod, I've also heard, in addition to our main event, Thunder versus Cahagas tonight, Big Ugly is going to be in the Grappler's Pit. Are you ready for that, my friend?
Yeah, I'm ready for that.
Your silence
so back
volumes.
To...
Your silence speaks volumes. All right, Patrick Large taking down Jeremy Blanchard, now targeting that left arm, Roddy.
Yeah, targeting. You know, Thunder, too, coming up. Thunder has got himself in a spot. He knows it. He's got a pin to Cahagas. He's trying so hard. I never seen such brotherhood between – oh, nice takedown by Jeremy. Between Hess and Thunder, and it's getting serious. Emotions are rising. They're talking about the – oh!
Whole lot on the line tonight. Now, right now, we've got to take a break. We'll be right back with more Portland Wrestling Uncut.
He's an ostrich.
Welcome back to Portland Wrestling Uncut. Joe V with the Hot Rod, Roddy Piper. Six-man match underway. And right now, Jeremy Blanchard tagging in Mike Santiago.
And here's the kid that we've all been watching, Santiago. Oh, nice knee right to the head. Santiago coming into his own. Lately, you know, he's been trying to fight. Ah, hard elbow to Patrick. Woof.
And is there a guy with a worse attitude? And I mean this in kind of in a good way, a me against the world attitude than Mike Santiago. He's out to prove something constantly.
He's got a laze on his shoulder.
Yeah, right.
A chip. Yes. A chip is on it. He's got a bag of lays on his shoulder.
Yeah, he's got a can of Pringles. He's got a case on there.
And you know, and he does, but I guess it might serve him right. Nice going into a wrist lock, then going, getting the tag. I don't know if that's a legal tag. I'd have to check it out, man. But, you know, I don't think.
Explain that to Bubba Blanchard, because I'm not. He's going to do his work here on Patrick Large. Sends him in there.
There he goes.
Nice arm drag. Bring it nice down 300 arm pounds drag. Of Bubba Blanchard there.
Yeah, it's a little hemorrhoid trouble there with Bubba, I think, with the screaming. But
all right, here comes that Toombs kid.
Come on, lad. Nice drop kick. They're working better as a team. You know, there you go. Go for the cover.
Jeremy breaks it up. Veterans too shot. Close to the corner there. What are you going to do? Of course, the veterans there, the tag team champions, the Blanchard brothers.
Yeah, but you don't forget who's in the corner.
Wait a second.
Teams.
Hold on. Bubba Plex.
Oh,
man. Look out. Nobody throws suplexes on this roster like Bubba Blanchard.
Nobody.
It's terrifying.
No, it is terrifying. A lot of frequent flyer miles.
All right. My Santiago coming in now.
Don't forget who's in the corner of Colt Toombs and Patrick Large.
That's right. They've got the maniac Matt Bourne, their new mentor, as their six-man partner. We have yet to see him in this match.
I think that Matt might be –
You know, I don't know what Santiago's trying to do.
Nice takedown. Okay, here comes the MMA. Pound and ground. And away he goes, looking for ears, looking for eyes. Go pick him up. Nice job, Colt.
Yeah, as you said, that MMA background coming in there. And now Patrick Large taking to the sky, dropping it on the elbow. And now an arm drag on Mike Santiago.
Yeah, I think a couple of chips just fell off that shoulder
exactly.
But Santiago, a tough kid. He's trying to make his mark here. And you know what? He's being vocal about it, but he's getting in there and doing it too.
All right, Patrick Large with a forearm shiver there to Mike Santiago, trying to wear him down. Another arm drag there.
Not much effect of the forearm shiver, but it put him in a position for Pat was wise enough to arm drag him and start all over again. Hey, ref. Hello. Can't see. Fingers in the eyes.
All right, Mike Santiago stretching the rules. Ref giving him a little leeway there, it looks like.
A little?
Yeah, okay, maybe a lot.
You know.
Cutting him off from the corner there, and yeah. Send him into the turnbuckle.
Now I got to get the ref. Oof. Yeah.
Mike Santiago getting a double sledge, brings him right down.
Right to the sternum. Dragon Patrick in the middle of the ring. Smart move, too. Oof. You know, Santiago, give him credit, dragging him in the middle of the ring so he can get a clean pin on him so he can't touch the ropes. Here, Pat trying to tag Colton, that's my son.
Yeah.
Couldn't remember his name.
Wait, he gets into the corner there, and Matt Bourne
finally
in the ring. He got the tag.
Here we go. We got the maniac. What?
Ref saying he didn't get the tag?
Oh, come on. He got the, I saw a tag. Did
referee,
you see a tag?
Tex Thompson, we may need to check his vision. He's missing a few details.
They definitely made the tag. Well, that's why there's no instant replay in pro wrestling. Now he's counting. It's good that the referee can count to three.
This is the clothesline. Here comes the sunset flip from Patrick Large. And
down. One, two. Yeah. Patrick.
Now, there's the tag.
Here come the maniac.
Can't miss that one. Throwing that left hand.
He says, bring him on in.
Matt Bourne, drop it up.
Bring him on in. Boom. Hello, Santiago. Bring it on. Yeah. One to the belly. And let me say hello. There you go.
A lovely bunch of coconuts there. And a left to the abdomen. And boom, down goes Bubba Blanchard.
Matt Bourne's a tough boy. I love him. I remember Matt Bourne when he was just a kid. You know, he wasn't that ugly then.
Well, he's come a long way since then. Now a mentor.
Yeah.
Toombs and Patrick Large.
And he's a beautiful guy, Matt Bourne.
The son of the legendary Tough Tony Bourne, who you knew very well, Rob.
Yeah. Every time I walk in the dressing room, Tough Tony Bourne, first thing you do is slap me in the face, then say hello. Oh, and that's kind of what's happened to Cole.
Look at those shots from Jeremy Blanchard.
Pretty serious shots going on.
He's a good 260, 270, and every ounce of that's behind those punches. And an avalanche right there.
And down on the neck. Colt not knowing where he is right now.
All right, we get it, Jeremy. You may want to handle your business there. Don't get too distracted.
Yeah.
Head in there now to tag in the heat seeker, Mike Santiago. Taking it back to Colt Toombs.
The Heat Seeker.
Yes.
Did you just make that up?
Well, he calls himself the Heat Seeker.
Oh, he
Puerto
does.
Rican. I kind of abbreviated that.
I gotcha. You did good there, Joe.
All right.
Mike Santiago, not so good. Got stuck in the corner. Nice uppercut.
Nice uppercut for Patrick Large and a dropkick. This guy can take to the sky, Rod.
Nice. Santiago now earning his stripes. Didn't know what to do. Kind of a pause. About San Diego, I would have went for the leg dive. Now Patrick, I don't know what he's doing.
Large. I think he's going for the large bomb. But
he's
Santiago's
trying for
cutting
a sunset
it off.
Flip. Couldn't get it done. You know, there's a size.
Look at this. Oh, my gosh. Fisherman suplex into a small package, and he got it.
Holy cow.
Wow.
Where did that come from?
What a maneuver by Mike Santiago getting the pinfall.
Colt Toombs and Patrick Large are learning a lesson here. They've just been taking school.
Well, you know, Matt Bourne said he wanted to teach him a lesson. I think Mike Santiago just taught him a lesson on television, Rod.
Yeah.
That's the greatest thing the Northwest ever seen right here.
That's Fifi at work. The Fifi philosophy came through again.
If you say so, Mr. Ruella. Matt Bourne, not looking too happy.
Nah,
we'll be right back. More Portland Wrestling.
Bad
Uncut.
Bad look. Matt just left him.
This segment is brought to you by Rick's Auto Sales in Rainier.
And welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another edition of the Grappler's Pit.
Oh, boy, Roddy. I hope you have your DVR set. It's time for the Grappler's Pit.
Segment I got.
Oh, isn't that
great? The one thing I thought of brought all the ratings to the television station. Everybody dies to see it. It's the Grappler's Pit. And the one reason they like to watch this is because a big man like this right here, Exile. But you know something? They got a lot of tough guys at Portland Wrestling Uncut. And there's one guy, our heavyweight champion, He is going to be my special guest on the Grappler's Pit tonight. I want to bring out Big Ugly. Come on out, Ugly!
All right, here he comes, the Pacific Northwest Heavyweight Champion, Big Ugly. 2 weeks ago, he defeated Tabori. That belt looks good on him, right?
Yeah, that's a great introduction by the Grappler there of Big Ugly. Not that I would know, I'm just saying.
It's a groundbreaking segment.
It was definitely groundbreaking.
Big Ugly fought Exile in a tag match last week, you'll remember.
Yes, I do.
Teaming with Big Fluffy, who we'll see later in the show.
So, Ugly, if you quit kissing butt and get in here and talk to me. How's it feel to be a champion there, Ugly, since I had it 7 times, not once like you?
Well, you may have had the belt 7 times, but it's only because you lost it 7 times. Yeah! I'm the champion.
It must be that new groundbreaking segment he's got.
You better thank God that I don't wrestle anymore, because that belt would be around my waist, boy.
We're all happy you don't wrestle anymore because apparently Colt Toombs took care of that for us.
I tell you what, Hotshot, you got a big mouth to go with that heavyweight belt. There's a guy standing right here named Exile. I believe he deserves a shot at it. He's probably beat you 100 times on the road. Why don't you give him a title shot and put that belt up where your mouth keeps flapping all the time, huh?
You see, Grappler, Exile, or Gabba Gabba, as I like to call you, I would love to give Exile a title shot. And believe me, Exile, I've said more than anybody how bad of a man I think you are. You're so bad. Let me show you how bad you are. Roll the video.
Big man, are you going to kick some butt today?
Well, I'm going to tear him apart, boss.
I'm Exile, the boss. This man, Exile right here, has the charisma of Stephen Hawking.
You know something? You can avoid the situation all you want to by running your mouth and making fun of Exile. But you know what? The point is,
I'm going to tear him apart, boss.
Are you going to put the title on the line or not?
I'm going to tear him apart, boss.
Oh, put it this way. I would love to tear him apart, boss, but let's watch the video one more time.
I'm going to tear him apart, boss.
Exile does not see the humor in this, right?
My point is, are you putting the belt up or not? Man or mouth, squeak up, boy.
Well, I'll tell
you. Look at
Exile.
I'll
tell you this. I'll put this title on the line when Exile rolls his shorts down to the level they're supposed to be. You see, most people just go to the gym and work out, but I guess if you roll them up by your chi-chis, it means you're more impressive. But if you want to see why Exile does not deserve a title shot, let's see his Oscar-winning performance one more time.
I'm gonna tear him apart, boss.
Okay, a great deal of fun at the expense of Exile, who does not look happy.
Yeah, you know everybody laughing but Exile.
Why don't you just admit it and tell everybody you're scared of the big man?
Okay, Betty White. I'll tell you like this. If you think that me or anybody out here is a scared to wrestle Exile, then not only are you crazy, you must be
stupid! Oh my God!
Leveled him! He is out!
Big Ugly kept pushing and pushing and pushing Exile's buttons, and finally the monster exploded with a massive right hand, Rod.
He is out! Look at that man.
One punch.
Well, you know what? One step too far. Look at the grappler. Nobody's saying nothing.
Exile.
Nobody's cheering Ugly.
Has just knocked out the heavyweight champion.
We need to take a break.
We'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to Portland Wrestling Uncut one of the top comedians in the world today, Mr. Gabriel Iglesias.
Uncut, bringing you it all. Bringing you the top comedians, top wrestlers, even exile.
All right, the Fluffies guys back with us. He's got a guest. We'll get to that in just a sec. But Gabriel, you were here last week on Portland Wrestling Uncut. You actually wrestled in a match. What did you think? What was your experience like here on Portland Wrestling Uncut?
Oh man, it was scary. I'm not gonna lie. You know, it looks a lot easier than it really is. I was happy. It was a lot of fun, and I was in the corner, and I got some ugly stares, and I had a little magical help right here.
Yeah. Now, I want to ask you about that. You were able to get the win over Dr. Cleaver with a little assistance from this masked luchador. Came out of nowhere. Came from under the ring. Who is this person?
I had him in my back pocket. And when times got tough, I just pulled him out and, you know, dale gas and go tear it up. And I want to introduce to you guys here in the, you know, in the room and to the people all around Portland. This is the new man that's going to take over. His name is Azul Angel. Means blue angel in Spanish, for those of you that don't speak Spanish. But Vato, really? That's the only word you got right now. All right. Azul Angel from the ghetto. So it's going to be good, and he's amazing.
I understand he's going to have a match right now. You going to stick around and watch it?
Yeah, I'm going to stick around, and something happens, I'm going to have to get in the ring again.
All right. All right, Gabriel, thank you for joining us. We'll see you at ringside, and Azul Angel's going to have a match right now. Thank you, sir.
Tear it up, man.
Azul Angel is heading to the ring for his opponent. Let's send it up to Devin Dawson. Devin.
And his opponent from Los Angeles, California, the little chocolate drop, CJ Edwards.
All right, Rod. The Azul Angel. That's Blue Angel.
Thank you from the ghetto.
Making his in-ring debut.
Now, does that
CJ Edwards?
CJ Edwards, is that a new name for it? No push? Is that
no push? No idea.
No idea.
Well, let's see how he does. You know, the luchador Azul Angel. Oh dear. Azul Angel taking a little break there. So last week, Roddy, you saw during that tag match, he came out and took out Dr. Cleaver, which is not an easy thing to do.
Not at all.
And let Gabriel Iglesias claim the victory.
You know, but let's see what he's got in the full meal deal here. He's with CJ now. CJ knows what he's doing. CJ going for the wrist lock right away. Nice nip up. Oh, nice.
I have a feeling, Rod, we're going to see some moves that we've never seen, or at least I've never seen before. They may defy description.
Nice. You know, it's the luchador style. And these guys are great. They can move. They know where they're at all the time. They do some sensational aerial stuff. And obviously, a friend of Gabriel's, he wanted to introduce him and give him a little push. Gabriel's that kind of guy, you know. He'd give a friend a push. Had me do the Harlem Shake. Want to thank you for that. A big one in my career. Nice move.
Ooh, look, nice mat wrestling there from CJ Edwards. Who, like the Azul Angel, is known as a high flyer. Yeah. Kind of a cruiserweight, but he can work on the mat as well.
Absolutely.
Let's see here. What's the Azul Angel doing? A little tango there, it looks like. Oh. Right? Get out of that arm bar.
Yeah, and a little pump, little pop to the sternum as he's going through into the headlock. See, they're very technical. Very, very, very enjoyable to watch.
You've wrestled all over the world. Obviously, people know about your, you know, confrontations with people like Chavo Guerrero and great Latino wrestlers. Is there a difference in wrestling a luchador as opposed to, say, a typical American wrestler?
Oh, big time. The luchadors, like I've wrestled a lot in Mexico City, Mil Mascaras, El Santo I even wrestled. Oh, nice. You see, it's stuff like that they'll do. you least expect, but I found the easiest way is just knock them out, ground them. You got to ground these guys,
yeah.
Because otherwise they'll be all over you. In Mexico, when I was in Mexico City, wrestling Mil Mascaras, he was always in the air. First time I got a hold of him and got him on the ground, then, you know, you kind of take away all their, the basis of all their moves. But a nice suplex. Again, you notice how they always come out on top. They're very aware of where they are.
It's very fluid, moving from one move to the next. He went right from that suplex into a pinning combination there, wasn't able to get it, but just keeps moving. Not a lot of downtime for the Azul Angel.
No, and with CJ.
Ooh, nice super kick there by the Angel.
CJ should, like, get a little push going here, because he's dying.
All right, Azul Angel picking up C.J. Edwards, the little chocolate drop, he calls himself. Well, he just got dropped by the blue one.
You see,
springboard.
Lands on his feet there. You never know. Missed. And nip. Oh, nice move by C.J. That's what's great about these guys.
Nip up into an enziguri on the mat there. I've never seen that. I don't know. I just got my wrestling dictionary out right now and learned that move. Flying knee in the turnbuckle there by C.J. Edwards, finally getting some offense in. And he's going for a bulldog, but shrugged off by the Angel into a hurricane rana. Roddy, I can't keep up with it.
Holy cow, they are flying. And that's what the beauty. Oh, nice. Nice hook by C.J. C.J. going into a grip. Now I don't know where. Up
walking
to the top
ropes.
Bang, man, and what the heck was that?
My goodness. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the latest production from Cirque du Soleil. This is amazing. Flying all over the place.
They are amazing. Great entertainers, great wrestlers.
All right, C.J. Edwards. Crowd getting behind him and the Angel as well. Really don't know. The crowd seems to be behind both of these guys.
CJ's pushing for them to be behind him, but not having a lot of luck with it. But, you know, the Blue Angels being endorsed by Gabriel, who, again, you know, big-hearted guy. I love the guy to death. If you ever get a chance to see Gabriel Iglesias perform, you go see him perform. CJ going up to the top rope, going to do some form.
Look at that. Azul Angel catches CJ as he's climbing to the top rope there.
Yeah, and, you know, right down there with the family.
Yes. Yeah. All right. It looks like he's got him in a fireman's carry here, Rod?
Yeah,
what's going on here?
Fireman's carry.
Drops behind him.
Look out. Oh!
Belly flop onto the mat. For
that's the kind of stuff they get into where they get hurt in bad guys.
Again, a seated hurricane rana there from C.J. Edwards.
Tremendous performance.
Head. These two high flyers really showing everything they've got to the audience here at Portland Wrestling Uncut.
Look like CJ getting a little frustrated there. They're going for the pin. You know, they're so fast, they try to get the pin. The referees, American referees, it's hard to keep up with these guys because you've got to get down on that mat and get that count. Like right now, that referee's got to be down on that mat because you never know. There you go, boom. See, there's a wasted count there. That's a two, but that really would have been a three, wouldn't it, Joe?
Absolutely.
So that's now there's
Fluffy guy looking on, enjoying himself, ladies
he
and gentlemen.
Little concern, maybe.
Still have some great action to come. Thunder is facing Cahagas tonight. He must pin him to free Wade Hess from his contract, and Wade will be in action in our next match. And we've already seen Exile laying out Big Ugly. I mean, what a night it's been. More to come. Here, C.J. Edwards taking down Azul Angel, going for the pinfall. Not so fast.
No, there's still a lot of kick left in the Blue Angel. Blue Angel, is that?
The Azul Angel,
Azul.
If you want to use the Espanol.
Okay, Azul.
There, Rod? Yes. And actually, in Spanish, I believe it would be Angel, but I'm just... That's that's my high school Spanish teacher
speaking
there.
Well, I'm going to get my Rosetta Stone out. And,
there you go.
You know, nice kick by C.J.
All right, C.J. Edwards snap marrying down Azul Angel.
Oh!
He really knows how to use those feet. A lot of kicks from C.J. Educated feet, as they like to say.
Educated feet, goes for the cover. Again, you see, these are American referees. The Mexican referees, Spanish referees, they're down there right away. So I think counts are being missed. But then again, you're in Portland.
There you go.
Oh,
all right.
Nice.
Now, Azul Angel with some kicks of his own.
Yeah.
He does have a little bit of a size advantage there on C.J. Edwards. Oh, and look at that.
Everybody's got a size advantage on C.J. Edwards.
A somersault dropkick by the Azul Angel.
Oh,
missed. The spinning kick.
Oh,
and an insert of his own. Impressive. Off the ropes, Azul Angel.
Nice move, that one. And that's that's a two.
C.J. got out.
Holy cow.
Wow, that was impressive.
C.J.'s a tough kid.
All right, here he comes. Off the top rope now. Oh, my God. Was that a 450, a 720? I don't know what you call that. A 1080.
East German judge gave it a 4.5.
Impressive. C.J. goes for the pin, but wait a minute. Azul Angel, one, two,
and
three.
He got a three.
Oh.
Holy cow.
All those high fly moves, but in the end, it's a simple, small package
Azul
to get the victory.
Angel.
Azul Angel.
What a great performance.
All right.
And there's Fluffy.
Gabriel Iglesias.
Yeah.
Very happy for his new friend, Azul Angel. Right now, let's go backstage to Josh Wilcox.
Thanks, Joe. This is Josh Wilcox with 1080 The Fan, helping out here at Portland Wrestling Uncut. I'm down here to talk to Wade, by God, Hess. Wade, what's the thing going on with the grappler? You know, there's a lot of problems with Len Denton. the grappler. Let me tell you.
Wait a minute. First of all, what are you telling people my name for? Okay, I'm wearing a mask. You call me the grappler. And why is he talking to the media? Are you a manager or a wrestler? You cannot get nothing straight, can you? When I tell you to beat somebody up, you stand back and you're shaking the fans' hands. You can't do what I tell you to do. You're going to get fired. You keep it up. You know, Wilcox, I want one question. I want you to answer one question for me, okay? You have the radio show, right?
Yeah.
Okay. You have Roddy Piper on there. You have all kinds of stars on there. You're looking at a legend in Portland wrestling, the grappler. How come you hadn't had me on there?
Well, you're on the list. I mean, you know, you are a legend. I have a lot of respect for what you've done, but, I mean, we're talking Roddy Piper, Chael Sonnen, Kyle Turley, Mike Ditka. Where do you rank amongst those guys?
Amongst those guys? Where do they rank amongst me? Okay? You ever been on the grappler's pit? One day, maybe you'll have the opportunity. But you know what, Hess? Let me talk to you for a minute. Here's the weak link in my chain right here. Okay? I got a match for you tonight, all right? I'll set you up a match. I want you to go out there. I want you to prove to me what kind of man you are. I want you to beat the heck out of this guy, tear him up, and pin him so you can show all the fans that you deserve to be in my stable. You know what they used to say about me when I was a wrestler? They used to say they got a name for you when you're the greatest wrestler in wrestling today. They don't call you a great wrestler. They call you the grappler. So beat me if you can. That's what I wanted to say about you. So let's go do it. Come on.
Welcome back to Portland Wrestling Uncut. The grappler dragging weight by God Hess. Now, Roddy, you remember it was last week. Kahagas, the Tokyo Monster, was attacking Buddy Highway with a kendo stick. Wade Hess threw his body over Buddy to save him, and then the grappler ordered Kahagas to hit Wade, to hit his own man. That brought out Thunder, and we're going to see Thunder and the Tokyo Monster do battle tonight. Hold on a sec here.
And his opponent,
Exile's dragging out
202 pounds from South Beach, Oregon. Nate Andrews.
Now, apparently, we're supposed to have a match with Wade Hess. Nate Andrews, for people who don't know, Nate Andrews is one of Wade Hess's best friends. It's actually his former roommate.
So the grappler's trying to get Hess to beat up his roommate, who's about 100 pounds lighter.
He's saying he wants you to beat up.
Yeah, it's getting personal.
One of his close friends.
I don't like this at all.
Is he trying to prove a point to Wade? I mean, he was saying in that interview before we went to break, he wanted Wade to be meaner and more cutthroat. I guess.
Yeah.
He wants Wade to prove himself to him here. Is that the idea?
I think the idea is that he has total control over Wade. Wade's got to do what he's got to say because Wade's under contract. But this year, there's no sport in this.
Yeah.
These two guys are friends.
Wade, you can tell, does not want to fight his friend.
Nah, but Grappler holds a contract. He's getting angry.
Okay. You can tell Wade, obviously, very reluctant. Nate doesn't want. He was dragged out here by Exile. Obviously,
yeah,
with the Grappler's orders.
You know, there's a lot of bullying going on here, and I hate a bully. Well, I hate a bully in any context, and I don't like what the Grappler's doing.
Now,
what's
going on here?
Hang on.
That's, are you kidding me?
You know what? There's no.
And the referee's not doing anything. What is going on here? Is this even a match?
No, it's out of control. That's what it is.
So now Grappler beats up Nate Andrews.
Now, wait a second. Whoa!
Oh, my goodness.
Holy cow.
Slaps Wade Hess. Wow.
Yo, this is going to get out of control.
He told him to pin Nate Andrews.
Now, that's his best buddy, right?
I mean, this is why Wade Hess wants out of that contract. He's tired of working for the grappler. The grappler's saying, what's going on here?
What are you doing?
He's pulling Nate Andrews on top of him. Rod. Now he's telling the refs to count?
You know what he's doing? He's telling the grappler to stick it where the sun don't shine. What he's doing, Hess is saying, I don't care what you say. I'm not your boy. There's our winner, Nate Andrews.
Wow.
Look at the grappler. All of a sudden, yeah. How do you feel like being a bully? You like being a bully? That man there is not a bully. That's a stand-up man.
Wade Hess
told
the
grappler.
You know what?
You get the hell out of here.
He's done with him, but he's still under contract. And the grappler, wait a minute. Now this is unnecessary. The match is over, and the grappler sends an X with the spear. almost rips Nate Andrews in half. I cannot believe this.
Getting personal.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got to take a break. But coming up next, Thunder is going to fight Cahagas. And if he pins Cahagas, Wade Hess will be freed from the grappler's contract. That's coming up next.
I hate a bully.
This is unnecessary.
No, it's ridiculous.
All right, Nate Andrews getting some help.
It's ridiculous. That's enough. It's enough of this.
All right, we'll
be
right back.
Take it off of you. That's what Portland Wrestling Uncut's all about.
Thunder, it's great to see you. You brought not only your son, Bobo, who we know very well. This is actually Dominic. This is Wade Hess's son. You've got your match with the Tokyo Monster. Why do you have these two young men out here with you right now?
You know, to be honest with you, Wade and I go way, way back. Originally from a small town a little south of here named Albany. You know, I grew up in with the Liberty Grade School. We ended up both moving to Salem. He went to Waldo Junior High, went to McKay High School, and I ended up graduating from North Salem High School. I mean, so we've been tight for a very long time. And this is my nephew, my son. You know, we're all family.
Now, you are fighting Tokyo, the Tokyo Monster, to release Wade from his contract with the grappler. Now, we've already seen the match you had with Shane Douglas a couple weeks ago. You were told you had to pin him. He got an intentional disqualification. You won the match, but you did not free Wade from his contract. Once again, you have to get the pinfall against Cahagas, the Tokyo Monster. It can't be a DQ. It can't be a countout. Thunder, look, a lot of us are concerned. We think you're in a no-win situation here.
Bottom line is, I can't win. No matter what, they're going to DQ, they're going to walk out, they're going to leave. I'm never going to get to 1-2-3. So maybe eventually, but right now, I can't win.
So why are you doing this then?
For these two right here. For my family.
All right, well, Thunder, best of luck. I tell you what, I'm going to take the kids to the back. You go have your match, and best of luck. We're all pulling for you, okay? All right, big man, thank you very much. Kids, let's head to the back. Thunder's heading to the ring. Here to introduce his opponent, Mr. Devin Dawson. Devin.
And his opponent, from Japan, the Tokyo Monster, Cahagas.
Well, I'm speechless a little bit. I've got kids. I've fed kids my whole life by being a fighter. I feel for Thunder so much. I've never seen a man with so much courage. At the same time, look at what he's facing. The grappler, the epitome of a bully, what I saw just a segment before. I got no use for that. This guy, Tokyo Monster, he is a monster. He's one of the best in the game right now. They pushed your back, Joe.
Yeah, hey,
no,
Rod.
Just let me finish, because they pushed. I was just letting them know that... you know, Thunder, so much courage. He's got his boy out there. He's facing a guy that is top of his game. There's no way out for this kid.
And I was just going to say, walking backstage, I just ran into Wade Hess. He took the kids. He wanted them apparently to come out with him. But look what's going on here. Thunder's been attacked by Cahagas.
Yeah, and now here's the thing. Like, jeez. It's the ultimate of bully. Thunder's such a...
See, that's what I'm saying. Wade's got the kids now, and he's bringing them out. And apparently he's going to sit at ringside and watch this match. Ladies and gentlemen, for people who haven't been following, Wade has signed a contract several weeks ago, a couple months ago, actually, with the grappler. He's come to regret that decision, basically. He regrets signing that contract.
Well, what's happened is the grappler put him in a spot. The grappler's an old-timer, and he put him in a spot, and he says, if you can pin this man. And Thunder, being an emotional kind of guy, he said, sure I can, but they just keep getting DQ'd, and there's no way out for Thunder. There's no place for him to go. Now, Hess is under contract to grappler.
Now, wait a minute. I think grappler hit him with the kendo right in front of the referee. Referee's going to get the disqualification. No, wait a minute. Thunder's saying, don't disqualify him. Don't disqualify Cahagas. He needs that pinfall to free Wade from his contract. So he's asked the referee not to make the disqualification.
They need to take the kids out of here.
Yeah. This is ugly,
Look
ladies and gentlemen.
Tokyo Monster's nobody to be messed with. Tokyo Monster will hurt you. He's supreme at what he does. He's one of the top talents in the country today. He knows what he's doing.
And Thunder has to get the pinfall, as we've said time and time again. It can't even be... Oh, what is going on? Kendo stick. I mean, they've got to stop the
match.
No,
it's the ultimate bully.
The Thunder was telling him, Thunder's telling the referee, no, please do not disqualify him. I need the pinfall. He doesn't want to win that way, Roddy. He won't be allowed to win that way.
Yeah, but all that's going to happen, he's going to get hurt so bad in front of his family. That's I hate this.
This is not a wrestling match. This is a mugging. This is a borderline crime.
It's bullies. That's all it is. These guys both know they got Thunder. Nice. Thunder. Nice. If Thunder could just come up with a pin. Come on, bud. Just snatch his butt and pin him.
All these kendo shots, all these cheap, dirty tricks. Nonetheless, Thunder has a warrior spirit. He's going to fight back. And as he said, he's doing it for his family, his brother-in-arms, Wade Hess.
And you know why they keep trying to get DQ'd? Because the bottom line is they can't pin Thunder either.
No. No, and Thunder will never quit. I mean, that we know. Thunder is a man who quits not in his... What is going on here? Are you kidding me, the ring bell?
Somebody needs to get out.
This is ridiculous. All right.
It's out of control.
Referee needs to stop this match.
It's out of control.
Thunder's telling him no. He's holding on to the referee's hand, saying, don't make the call. Now, wait a second.
Blocks it. Thunder, go! Go!
Wade's at ringside now. Oh! Low blow by Cahagas. I mean, these should all be disqualifications, but... At Thunder's behest, the referee's allowing it. Thunder wants to get... Wade Hess said, let it go. He's telling him quit. He's saying, give up. It's Wade's contract at stake. He's telling his brother, Thunder, don't do this for me.
I can't watch this.
And there's Dominic and Bobo at ringside.
That's too strong.
Watching Thunder basically sacrifice his body for his best friend and longtime partner, really his brother. Wade
Come
Hess.
On, Thunder.
All right.
Come on, bud. Just one quick pinfall. Here we go. Go for it.
Oh, wait a minute.
Ah.
Kind of a guillotine choke there with that body scissors. Oh, he's trying to choke the life out of Thunder after all those kendo shots.
Thunder's so strong.
Look at the power of Thunder. Into the
turnbuckle. So strong. We set so much take. So much take.
The kid's cheering on. As Thunder said, this is for his family. He's giving it everything he's got. It doesn't matter what the grappler throws at him. He's going to keep going. You're going to have to drag Thunder out of the ring to stop this thing.
That's just about what they're doing. That's what Hess is trying to do.
Hess is saying let it go.
He's letting it go.
Now he's got the sleeper.
Hooking in a sleeper. You know, he's got it hooked in. Now maybe Thunder gets his chin down under there. He stands a chance, but the amount of punishments he's taken.
Dominic's trying to cheer up Bobo. Those kids have known each other their entire lives.
Get the kids out of there.
Yeah, it's unfortunate that they have to watch this. It's unfortunate that anybody has to watch this, quite honestly, what's going on with Thunder right now. This is not a wrestling match.
No, this is not what...
But wait a second. His arm did not drive the third time. Thunder still has fight in him, and he's fighting off the Tokyo Monster.
Nice move by Thunder. Come on. Cover him. Cover him.
Somehow, Thunder...
Thunder, he's
has come back.
Too much has been taken out of him.
But Wade Hess looking on concerned, as well he should be, as we are all. We are all concerned right now, quite honestly.
Wade Hess is just telling him to quit.
No!
Stop, it's not working.
Thunder won't quit. He keeps shaking it off. Wait a minute.
That's why he's...
Kendo stick again.
Don't forget.
And now he's choking him. He's trying to choke the life out of Thunder. All he wants to do is help his brother, and this is his reward. This is criminal. This is ridiculous. They need to ring the bell. Stop this thing. Somebody needs to just get in there and stop this thing, Rod.
That's enough. I'm going to stop in a few seconds if they don't.
Come on.
That's not what Portland Wrestling is about. Portland Wrestling.
Thunder's trying to find the strength to overcome this.
Don't forget, he is the recipient of the Thunder Award of Curry. He can't quit. He's backed into a corner. He's got his boy watching. He's got his best friend on the line. What's he supposed to do?
Wait a second. Here we go. Big Ugly's now in the ring. Finally, some sense. Somebody's come to the aid of Thunder.
Cole Toombs.
Cole Toombs in the ring. The locker room's clearing out. These guys.
Patrick Large.
They've all come to Thunder's aid.
Tokyo Monster's out.
About time.
Blue Angel.
Put an end to this.
CJ.
Huh. I mean, that was excruciating to watch. And finally, I think the boys in the locker room had enough.
I have had it with the grappler and all this crap that he's coming out here doing with all these people in the ring.
I've had enough, too.
It's bad enough
that every time we come out here, half the time we get screwed by the promoter on our money. The only thing we have is you fans who help bring us food. And we're trying to come out here and earn a living, not only for us, but for our family, and guys like the Grappler try to take that away from us. I could easily go back in that locker room and take the Grappler apart. I could easily meet him in the parking lot and kick the hell out of him. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hurt this company and make them give us what we want. So next week, if the commissioner, if either, I don't care if it's the commissioner, Roddy Piper, or somebody with some power, better come out here and hear our grievances and fix these problems, or we're going on strike.
I'm going on strike right now.
Where are you going?
And I tell you this, if we go on strike and you people are pissed off about it, then we riot.
All right, Roddy Piper's left the announce booth.
So, Grappler, you better make the choice. You better man up. Because if you think anybody in this building is here to see you or your guys, not only are you crazy, you must be stupid.
Wow. Okay. Big Ugly, the whole locker room says it's time for a change. We'll see what happens. Good night, everybody.